In this video, I'll explain cost-benefit analysis. By the end of this video, you'll be able to explain how to conduct a cost-benefit analysis. You'll also learn how to analyze the limitations of a cost-benefit analysis. When considering whether or not to pursue a public investment project, such as building a highway or installing a traffic light, a government would undertake a cost-benefit analysis to assess the value of the project and also see whether or not they should progress with it. The issue lies in determining the value of benefits and costs. How do we appraise the present value of some future benefits? While we can gather as much information as is available, accurately placing value on costs and benefits is quite a difficult process. I'll illustrate with an example. Imagine an intersection without stop signs or traffic lights. There's a significant amount of traffic that flows through the intersection on a daily basis, and from time to time there are accidents. The city is deciding whether or not to introduce traffic lights at the intersection. How would they value the benefits of putting up a traffic light? But while they're deciding whether or not to put up the traffic light, the following incident occurs. The drivers seen just before are continuing along their daily commute when one car breaks down in the intersection. For some reason, the van driver is playing on a mobile phone and doesn't look up in time to see the broken down car. There's a fatal car accident and neither driver survives. The question is, how do you place a monetary value on an individual's life or well-being? This is one of the many problems that governments face when pursuing such projects. It's somewhat easy to estimate the cost of the materials and services needed to put up the traffic light, but it's difficult to estimate the benefits accurately. Add to the problem that people don't pay to use the traffic light, and determining its value becomes much more difficult. Let's look at a sample analysis the government may conduct. This table considers four options and their associated benefits and costs. There are external benefits and costs for each option. We add together the private and external benefits and compare them to the private and external costs. We use this information to derive our net benefit or net cost. Using this information, we select the project with the highest net benefit to pursue. Let's consider option one. The sum of the benefits is $120,000 and the value of the cost is $180,000. Since our costs are greater than our benefits, we run a net loss of $60,000. Let's use the same approach to solve for the rest of the options and see if we can find one with a positive net benefit. Moving on to option 2, we can see that the sum of the benefits is $220,000 and the costs are $205,000. The net benefit is therefore $15,000. Moving on to option 3, we can see that the sum of the benefits is $230,000 and the costs are $220,000. The net benefit is therefore $10,000. Moving on to option 4, we can see that the sum of the benefits is $240,000 and the costs are $300,000. The net loss is therefore $60,000. If we select the option with the greatest overall benefit, then option 2 would be the obvious choice. Remember, just because we've identified the option with the greatest benefit, we should be careful about the value of the data collected. That plays a big role in the value of a project and the results of a cost-benefit analysis. All right, you've made it through the final video in Unit 1, and you should now have a good understanding of cost-benefit analysis. You've seen how to conduct one and have heard some of the limitations of being able to collect valuable data. If you have any questions, you can leave them below or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com or visit me online at www.enhancedtuition.co.uk. That's us done for now, and I will see you in Unit 2.